Welcome to Modern Group of Institution. In today's lecture of Pharmacology Second BP503T, we study about corticosteroid and special emphasis on glucocorticoids. Now, first of all, what are adrenal cortex steroidal hormones? So all the corticosteroids are steroidal hormone produced by the adrenal cortex. The adrenal gland contains two parts. The outer part is known as adrenal cortex and the inner part is known as medulla. There are two types of corticosteroids. They are known as glucocorticoids and mineral corticoids. The glucocorticoids are mainly corticosterone and cortisol, whereas the mineral corticoids are aldosterone. Now, glucocorticoid, where the word glucocorticoid comes from? The glucocorticoid word derived from word glucose plus cortex plus steroid. That is role of regulating glucose metabolism, adrenal cortex origin, and it has steroidal structure. Therefore, it is known as glucocorticoid. Contains glucose metabolism, cortex release from cortex area, and it contains a steroidal moiety. Endogenous glucocorticoids are part of feedback mechanism the body utilizes to reduce immunity activity. Exogenous glucocorticoids are used to treat disease caused by the overactive immune system, for example, allergies, asthma, autoimmune disease, and sepsis. Glucocorticoids are distinguished from mineral corticoids and sex steroids. They have different receptor, different target cells and effects. Now, what are mineral corticoids? The mineral corticoids are a class of steroid hormone that cause retention of sodium and water. They both are known as minerals. Aldosterone is the most important endogenous mineral corticoids. Aldosterone physiological role is an essential in the maintenance of adequate fluid volume needed for normal cardiac output and arterial blood pressure. Without adequate level of mineral corticoid, diminished cardiac output and can result in fatal shock known as hypovolemic shock. Elevated level of aldosterone associated with long term of stimulation of renin-angiotensin aldosterone system that you already studied in the previous classes of hypertension that is involved in the development of vascular remodeling and systolic heart failure. Now, in this lecture, we specially emphasis on glucocorticoids. Now, how hypothalamus regulate the release of the glucocorticoids and mineral corticoid, or combinedly we can get corticosteroids, or it is known as HPA axis, hypothalamus pituitary adrenal axis. First of all, hypothalamus is stimulated by negative feedback mechanism. Negative feedback mechanism is that when the concentration of the glucocorticoid and the mineral corticoid decrease inside the blood vessel, a message goes to the hypothalamus, there is a need of the mineral corticoids and glucocorticoid. At that time, the hypothalamus release corticotropin release hormone known as CRH. Now, this CRH stimulate anterior pituitary gland to release ACTH, adrenocorticotropin hormone, which further stimulate adrenal corticoid to release CORT, corticoid releasing hormone, cortisol. This is also known as HPA axis, how the corticosteroid are regulated inside the body with the help of the hypothalamus and pituitary gland. Now we are talking about the glucocorticoid, or in this lecture we specially emphasize only on the glucocorticoid, because the corticosteroid is a vast topic. So in this lecture, we only emphasize on the glucocorticoid action. The first action of the glucocorticoid, that it is responsible for the metabolism of the CHO, that is known as carbohydrates. It is responsible for the metabolism of fats, protein. So basically, the glucocorticoid, as we talk in the starting of this lecture, the glucocorticoid is mainly responsible for the metabolism of the carbohydrate, fats, and protein. It is responsible for the insulin resistance, hyperglycemia, and gluconeogenesis. Glucocorticoid is also useful in the breakdown of the protein, muscle wasting, and excessive urea production. Redistribution of the body fat, moon face, and buffalo lump is due to the excessive secretion of the glucocorticoids. Glucocorticoid has also a various important role in the metabolism of the calcium. It inhibits interstitial absorption and promotes excretion of the calcium. Loss of the calcium from the bone is due to the excess of the glucocorticoids inside your blood vessel. Negative calcium balance is maintained by the glucocorticoids. Now, glucocorticoid is also having action on your immunosuppressive and anti-inflammatory activity. It inhibits T lymphocyte action. As we all know, T lymphocyte and the B lymphocyte is responsible for our immunity, and glucocorticoid inhibit the T lymphocyte action and decrease the delayed hypersensitivity reaction. It also inhibits the synthesis of the prostaglandins and inhibits the synthesis of phospholipase A2 as well as COX-2. It also inhibits the mast cell, which releases the histamine and which is responsible for the allergic reaction. So it also inhibits mast cells, basophils, eosinophils, and degranulation of these all cells. It also inhibits glucocorticoids, inhibits the neutrophils and the macrophages migration. And this, by this action, it produces immunosuppressive activity as well as anti-inflammatory activity. Now, what are the more specifically action of the glucocorticoid? It is also used for the upregulation of anti-inflammatory genes, downregulation of the pro-inflammatory genes, and specifically, it play a very vital role in various inflammatory processes. Now, glucocorticoid further actions are, they are mainly responsible for the structural and functional maturation, or we can say development of the fetal lung. It is also used for the anti-stress agent in the central nervous system. It stimulates pepsin and gastric acid secretion, which leads to the fast metabolism or rapid metabolism of the carbohydrate, fats, and proteins. Now, if we talk about the pharmacokinetics of the glucocorticoids, hydrocortisone, one of the glucocorticoid, goes the first pass metabolism, whereas the synthetic corticosteroids are highly bioavailable after oral administration. Glucocorticoids mainly bind to the corticosteroid binding globulin known as CBG. As we all know, each and every drug inside our body bind to the some plasma protein. Similar to that, glucocorticoids bind only to the corticosteroid binding globulin. It can be given IV, IM, and topically as well as orally, whereas synthetic steroids reduced in the liver and produce active compounds. They are also sometimes known as prodrugs glucocorticoids or prodrugs corticosteroids.
What are the therapeutic use of the glucocorticoids? It is used in the it is used in the as an anti-inflammatory agent in asthma, the drugs beclomethasone, budesonide, flunisonide, and fluticasone are the example of inhaled steroid used in the treatment of the bronchial asthma. It is used for the oral candidiasis, thrush, and hoarse voice are the main side effect for inhaled corticosteroid. Due to the inhaled corticosteroid, these are the some adverse effect produced. Now, how glucocorticoids affect on the inflammatory cells, or how corticosteroid decrease inflammatory cells? Basically, eosinophils, number of apoptosis, in number of apoptosis decrease in the cytokines, decrease in the numbers of mast cells, decrease in the macrophages cells, and decrease in the dendritic cells. These are the effect of the inhaled corticosteroid. Leads to decrease in the cytokine mediators, decrease in the endothelial cell leak, and airways become smooth, and the person mucus secretion is decreased, and its treatment for the this proves how the glucocorticoid are active in the asthma treatment. The another use of glucocorticoid, it is used in the treatment of cancer such as lymphoma. As we already said previously, it decreases the number of cell or activity of the T lymphocyte. T lymphocyte is the lymphatic cell. When there is a lymphoma cancer, it is used for the treatment of such type of cancer which is related to the lymph node. By increasing the rate of apoptosis, it is used for the treatment of lymphoma. It is used for the organ grafting as an immunosuppressor. It is used for the anti-allergic for autoimmune diseases, and fetus lung maturation, it is used many times. The female carrying the fetus, the lungs are not well developed, and for that glucocorticoids are given for the maturation of fetus. Now, it is also used as an Addison disease. It is also known as adrenocortical insufficiency, where fludrocorticosone is administered to replace aldosterone and prednisolone, or methylprednisolone it administered to replace cortisol. A disorder occur when adrenal gland produce very little cortisol or too little aldosterone. The basic signs and symptoms of the Addison disease, that is extreme fatigue, weight loss, decreased appetite, hyperpigmentation of the skin, low blood pressure, hypoglycemia, gastrointestinal symptoms, muscle or joint pain, irritability, and the depression. This, as you can see in the picture, the various signs and symptoms of the Addison disease, that is bronze pigmentation of the skin, change in the distribution of the hair color, GI disturbance, weakness, hypoglycemia, postural hypotension, weight loss, profound fatigue, dehydration, vascular collapse, renal shutdown, decrease in the serum sodium and serum potassium. Now, what are the adverse effect of the glucocorticoid therapies? The adverse effect of the glucocorticoid therapies are hyperglycemia, that is the increase in the blood sugar level, and diabetes, central obesity, that is the belly fat, moon fat, and buffalo lung. It may cause weight loss, osteoporosis, poor wound healing, hypertension, and cataract. Another, adrenocortical overactivity. When the glucocorticoid secretion from the adrenal cortex increases, it leads to the Cushing syndrome. The Cushing syndrome can be defined as the Cushing gold. to remember glucocorticoid side effects. C stands for cataract formation and the glaucoma, whereas U stands for ulcer, S for skin, striata, thickening, H for hypertension and hyperglycemia, I for infection, N for necrosis or avascular necrosis of femoral head, G glycosuria, urine in the glucose in the urine, osteoporosis and obesity, immunosuppression and diabetes. So in simple term, we can say Cushing syndrome is the Cushing gold, and these are the various type of body changes present in the Cushing syndrome when there is overactivity of the glucocorticoids or overactivity of the adrenal gland or overactivity of the adrenal cortex, which release the glucocorticoid inside your blood vessel, leads to the Cushing syndrome. Now, what are the various treatment used for the Cushing syndrome, or we can say glucocorticoid synthesis inhibitors? First drug we use, that is aminoglutathimide. It blocks the enzyme conversion of cholesterol into pregnenolone into steroid synthesis, releasing the decrease in of the production of adrenal glucocorticoids, mineral corticoids, estrogen and androgen, and also block the conversion of the androgen to estrogen by inhibiting the aromatase enzyme, used in the treatment of Cushing syndrome, prostate and breast cancer. Second drug which we use for the treatment of Cushing syndrome or other type of disease and disorder which is caused by the oversynthesis of the glucocorticoids are this ketoconazole. It is basically an antifungal drug. It blocks the enzyme conversion of cholesterol into pregnenolone in steroid synthesis, resulting in the decrease in the production of glucocorticoids, mineral corticoids, estrogen and androgen, and used in the treatment of Cushing syndrome and prostate cancer. The next drug under this category is mitirapone, which selectively block the cortisol biosynthesis by inhibiting 11 beta hydroxylase enzyme. This result in increase in ACTH production by the pituitary gland, and which increase the adrenocortical secretion of precursor 11 deoxycortisol and deoxycorticosterone in plasma and in urine. Excessive excretion of the glucocorticoids by this drug leads to treatment or management of Cushing syndrome. It is sometimes also used as a diagnostic test for the knowledge of level of concentration of glucocorticoid synthesis. Now, one of the most important drug, that is glucocorticoid antagonist, that is mifepristone, a steroid that binds strongly with progesterone receptor and inhibit the activity of progesterone, whereas high doses exert anti-glucocorticoid activity. It is used for the induction of early abortion, can be used for adrenal carcinoma. Another glucocorticoid antagonist is mitotane. It inhibits the action of corticosteroid synthesis, that is directly selectively cytotoxic effect on adrenal cortex and cause adrenal atrophy, used in the adrenal carcinoma. Now, another drug is fludrocortisone. It is a mineral corticoid used for the regulation of fluid and electrolyte. So one thing coming in mind is that we are talking about the glucocorticoid and this drug is come under the mineral corticoid. Some of the glucocorticoid work as a mineral corticoid also. Therefore, fludrocorticoid is also used for the suppression or for the decrease in the secretion of the glucocorticoids. It act on the distal renal tubule, increase sodium reabsorption and potassium excretion, cause hypokalemia, and side effect is contraindicated with the patient already using loop diuretics or thiazide-like diuretics. It is taken orally for the adrenal insufficiency. Now, if we talk about the mineral corticoid antagonist, spironolactone, as we already studied in the diuretics, further, this drug inhibits the mineral corticoid receptor, MR receptor, in the distal convoluted tubule to promote the sodium and the water excretion and the potassium retention. It is used in the treatment of Kahn syndrome, also known as hyperaldosteronism. It is also used in the treatment of heart failure, hypertension, as a potassium sparing diuretic. It is also used as an anti-androgenic activity in the females having the mustache hair or development of the hairy development at the facial portion. We can use it as an anti-androgenic activity. Last one, that is known as eplerenone. It is similar to the spironolactone with a more specific action on mineral corticoid receptors. No anti-androgenic effect. It is used for the treatment of hyperaldosteronism, heart failure, hypertension, as well as potassium sparing diuretics. So that's all for now. Today we only studied about the glucocorticoid, which is a part of the corticosteroid. In the next lecture, we will study about the mineral corticoids, mineral corticoid structures, mineral corticoid synthesis, mineral corticoid actions, and mineral corticoids antagonists. Thank you very much.